All right, here we go. We use this bye week to get a little healthier, you know, clean things up in all areas. You know, it's beneficial to have this week just because that I hope it helps us down the stretch. Because we got five games back to back in a tough, physical Big Ten conference. So my thing is talking to the team that we gotta match our opponent physicality. And starting this week with Illinois. Illinois 17 ranked team is a well-deserved ranking. They have a really physical rushing game with Chase Brown Kitty's a really good runner, but they're really, really good on defense. You know, they top in the country in every category. They have a really good scheme, they're well coached, and they stick to their guns. So this week, you know, we're gonna need our fans on this one. We're gonna need our fans to be loud and help us out a little bit. Questions?
Can you give an update on Nick Hendrick?
Nick's gonna be out. Nick's gonna be out.
Is he out for the year?
He's out for the year.
What kind of hit was that? Knee, ankle, leg, or what type
of injury? Knee.
With injuries, real quick, too, will you get a Brock Bando back? And what's Kevin Williams' situation?
Well, Kevin's rehabbing right now. And so is Bando, but Bando's closer than Kevin.
Nicky, the last time you guys had a bye, you were going into the bye off of lost Oklahoma, and now you're coming in off two good performances and almost winning on the road in the Big Ten. I mean, did it feel different? Did it change any guys' kind of work during the bye now that you're finding the success?
Well, we had to get him healthy. We had to get him some rest. I understand what Casey said in his presser after the game. He needed to rest his body. So what we try to do is be smart with him. You know, during the bye week, you know, and get them out there, but also, you know, take the pads off and take the hitting off them. Okay, I'm done.
What makes their pass defense so good? Why are they so good?
Well, my dad always says men and women lie, numbers don't. So their number proved that they're pretty good. They're top five in every category, and it's a really sound defense. They don't do much, but what they do it very well. Very well, they're doing good.
Because they've got both sacks and they've intercepted, I think, 12 passes. Mm-hmm. Means they're kind of doing both things. That can sometimes be rare. Is there something that they're doing well to get all the interceptions?
Well, like I said, they don't do much. So they go, you know, you got this man and you're going to be over this center and let's play football. And it's simple, but like I said, they do it well and they well coach with their technique. So they play, their technique is really good.
After the game that Trey put on film, I mean, how much are you expecting teams to really go out of their way to make sure that doesn't happen again? And how do you combat that with some extra time to think about it?
Well, you know, if you look at it, you know, you had a really good game. But you would think that Illinois is going to do what they do. And they play man coverage, and they might try to bracket him. But I'm sure he's going to get more attention for the game that he had. Well, we got to get him going. We got to do a better job up front, you know, blocking and finding plays that we're comfortable blocking and finding plays that he's comfortable running. So we got to do a better job as a coaching staff to get that done. And we worked on that. The coordinator stayed in this week off the road from recruiting. So they worked on that. So maybe we can get this thing going this week. We got to get him going. You're right.
Nicky, how do you feel about the offensive line after the bye week? Did they get a chance to regroup a little bit and make you feel a little better about them?
Well, we beat up up front. You know, we down a couple of starters, but I feel good about them. I feel good about the bye week they had, and I felt good about their practice this morning. So they still giving us really good effort, and they really practice them really hard.
Mickey, what's the opportunity with some of your other receiving options to exploit that situation if opponents do start paying extra attention to what Trey does?
Well, it's probably a situation where I went through at LSU. You know, about the fourth game of the season, they started doubling Jefferson. And then Chase went off. Then Terrence Marshall went off. Then Clyde Allaire went off. So we're going to have options if they take Trey away. If they try to take Trey away, there's nothing we can do about it. But the other guys know they got to play football if that happens.
Nick, you said Illinois does a good job of sticking to its guns. If you make that a Nebraska discussion, what's that mean if you're sticking to your guns?
Well, we got to try to score points. We got to try to score points fast. I know everybody want to talk about the time of possession, But the offense scored 37 points, and I can't go to the offense and say, don't score in a minute. You know, I gotta let them score, you know, and the defense understands that. You know, so the time possession was a little off. But I think sticking to our guns, do what we do. You know, we want to throw the football. We want to throw the football, but we got to get Anthony going this week. We got to get him going. We got to get a running game going this week. Well, like I said before, you know, when I first took this thing over, is that we're going to do things the right way. We're not going to sabotage the program. We're going to go out and work like we're going to be here. So we sent our coaches out, I think they were in California, it was in Massachusetts. You know, I was in Atlanta. I was in Arizona. Fisher's in Florida, Dallas. So we went out. We went out as a staff. We kept the coordinators in. You know, the offensive, defense coordinators in. But we're going to recruit and, you know, find the pieces that we need. You know, and so we're going to go heavy JUCO when it comes to the offensive line. Yeah. You know.
How big can the JUCO angle be? You know, with the portal era, sometimes people didn't know exactly what was going to happen with junior college recruiting, but how useful is that still and important is that part?
I think the JUCO part is really important because you're getting the kid coming out of system. You get a kid coming out of portal, he's transferring for a reason. JUCO kid, you're recruiting him just like a high school kid. But a portal kid, he's transferring. He's a reason he's transferring. So you got to do more homework on a portal kid than you have to do a JUCO kid. JUCO kid, you can go to the coach and say, hey, you've been having it for 2 years. Tell me about it. But when a portal kid, now we got to go all the way back to high school to see what's the problem with this kid. Why is he transferring?
Did you get a chance to see Vance in Arizona?
I did. I had a chance to see Vance and listen to him about his two pick six. So
yeah,
he did a good job. He did a good job Thursday night. I told him he did.
How much have you relied on outside people like him? I don't know if you've talked to Coach O, but obviously he's been in the situation as an interim coach multiple times. What kind of value do those two in particular have they had in these 5 or 6 weeks for you?
Well, Coach O, you know, just speaking with Coach O, he always tells me just be myself. You know, make sure they get Mickey. And he knows there's nothing fake about me. I'm going to be Mickey. I'm not. You know, because at the end of the day, I can go back to Baton Rouge and that nice house in Baton Rouge and chill out. So I'm going to be Mickey. You know.
You got Malachi Coleman this weekend.
I wasn't finished answering that question.
All right. I didn't know. I'm sorry.
I'm just joking with you, man. You know, I was uptight. But no, you're right. We got Malachi.
Have you got a chance to talk to him?
Yes.
How'd that conversation go?
Well, he said it 6 months ago he wasn't coming here. So you put the pieces together.
Mickey, you know, it's a little bit of a 5-week stretch here to end the season. You know, what are you looking for in terms of intensity from the team to get through that 5-week stretch?
Well, a lot of energy, but we need to execute. We need with this football team is a really good football team when we execute in all three phases. So we're preaching to them that we need to execute. We need to execute the game plan.
How far away are you?
No, it's gotten a lot better. It's gotten a lot better. I mean, I like where they are right now. It's gotten a lot better.
How much better does it need to be to elevate for
one? Well, I mean, it's got to be up there, you know, because they're a physical football team, so we got to match their physicality.
I want to give you a chance to answer. Sure. Talk to Coach O. Who else?
Well, yeah, you know, Ogeron, he was really good. And like you said, be yourself. And then, you know, with Vance gives you – you know, just the plugs of being a head coach because he was head coach in Denver and it didn't go so well for him. So some of the things that he said he should have done that I need to do. But he always says, do it your way. He said, because then you won't regret anything if you do it your way.
Is there something that you can share with us that he shared with you about something you would have done differently that you are doing here?
Well, he shared this, and I'll leave it like this. I'm not going to make the decision if I get the job. I'm not going to make the decision. You know, that's going to be the administration that's going to make the decision if I get the job or not. So I got to just continue to get this team to get better every week and try to win football games.
What conversations maybe have you had in the last couple of weeks with Trev, maybe the 5 weeks or anything like that?
Just normal meeting. You know, normal meeting on Sunday. You know, that's it.
When you think about the Lima coach, Dylan coach team, what comes to mind first? Are there any defining elements that assist the over time?
Yeah, facing him when I was at LSU, he was at Arkansas. He's a very physical team. He wants to run the football. but he's physical across the board, offense and defense. He does a really good job with the defense and offensive line. He always had really good players in offense and defensive line, so you can see that now in Illinois, that they are really good players on both sides of the ball in the trenches.
With the Henrich injury, how valuable is a guy like Chris Velarovich, who's been around for a while? Just some of those younger guys behind him, how do you feel about that?
Well, they got to step up. They understand that. You know, they played snaps. You know, after Chris went down, they Chris and Vada played a number of snaps. Then Ernest went in. So all three of those guys got to step up.
Feel good about where Ryan was at?
Yeah, I feel good about Luke. Luke's back. I feel good about Luke.
After Anthony Grant, what does that number two running back spot look like? I know you've been a little shorthanded there last week.
Well, it'd be Yanni Ramirez, you know, until Gabe gets his, you know, feels better with his turf toe, but it'd be Yan and Ramir.
Chase Brown gets a lot of the attention on their offense, but obviously Tommy DeVito has had a pretty good season. What kind of stood out on film when you watch him play?
Well, he's another six-year senior, you know, 24 years old. I mean, he's going to have a lot of experience. He's going to know where to go with the ball, but he's a general. He controls that offense, and they know how to use him. And he's really good when they're running the football, but he won't make mistakes, and that's what we're going against again. You know, that a guy under the center that's not going to make mistakes.
How do you force a guy like that to make
mistakes? I guess I'll be able to tell you Saturday night about 6:30.
Hey, pursuant to the question about other receivers having to step up with each double cover tray, how do you feel like Marcus and Oliver, Brody, and Alonte have been playing in the last 4 weeks?
I thought they've been playing pretty well. I thought they've been playing well. I thought they've been open. You know, they've been open on occasions, and I think Oliver, you know, he always comes to the sideline and say, make him open. And when I look at the film on Sunday, he is open. He's a kid that can run with really good receiver skills. And Brody and Marcus, they you know, they understand what's going to happen if they double train, what they need to do. And Alonte also.
You coach a lot of fast receivers. Is Trey's top end speed towards the top of the guys you coach?
He's the fastest.
Fast in all of
those. He's fast in all those guys, yeah.
Why wasn't able to?
Well, I think because Justin Jefferson, Terrence Marshall, a lot of NFL guys were in that room. And over there, you had to wait. You had to wait, you know. And so he was in a loaded room. You know, if you look at it, all those guys are in the league, Grayson McMath, Derek Dillon, Stephon Sullivan, all those kids are in the league. So it was clicking there. But you had to really come to practice every single day and get it done. If not, the next guy was going to pass you up. So I think he grew up here. He grew up and he matured here when he got here, and he understand, okay, this is what I need to do to get better. Because remember now, Trey's been the best player on the field from the age of 5 all the way to 17 until he got to college. So it's hard for him to, like, I got to compete every down now. You know, Jamar had to learn that. Terrence had to learn that. Jefferson had to learn. They all had to learn that. And Trey just happened to be in a room with some first-rounders.
Mickey, still making plays, mm-hmm. and as a true freshman, what kind of attributes does he have that, you know, other than the physical side, that
could allow him to get off the field? Well, he's a strong-minded kid. He's a kid out of Mississippi, you know, tough kid, get after you, but he's smart. You know, he's smart. He understands the coverage. He understands leverage. And he's getting better every day at practice. He's getting better. And he understands that he's a freshman and that they're going to throw at him. He understands that. He welcomes the challenge.
Coach, last 3 games, you guys have been able to make really effective second half adjustments. What do you think it's about your staff and your team that you guys are able to do that so often?
Well, you take your hat off to the coaching staff, you know, coming up with a different plan the second half to see what's going to work and from the first half, what didn't work. Then you take your hat off to the kids, you know, for executing the plan. So it's a lot of work that go on at halftime.
Do you find yourself still having to build the kids' confidence up, and do you often still tell them, hey, the West is still there for the taking?
Well, you know, we show them where they're at. You know, we show them that they're right there in the middle, and they're going to play the number one team in the West this week. So they still control their own destiny. But, you know, I think their confidence is there right now. They believe that they can win. You know, just noticing on the flight home after the Purdue game and the look on their face, they were hurt. They were hurt. They were upset that they let that game go, you know, that – And I got, like I said, I got to do better with them. I got to get them over that hump. But they're a different team. They're a different team.
When did you see that switch flip with them?
Right after the Oklahoma week, you know, after everything settled down for him and they start believing in what we were doing. And so it's right after the Oklahoma week. Well, I think, you know, our crowds, we have some of the best fans in the country. And just being loud and being into the game and trying to disrupt their offense and try, you know, where they don't get the clap and what they do on offense, but just being loud and being there to support us.
We can ask Bill this too, but how far along did you mark Buck and Billy Morrison sort of the backup there? I'm not sure it's tough. Or did they contribute the last 5 weeks?
Yeah, they've been playing better. They've been playing better once we took over. I wanted to make sure that they played, because I think game reps is going to help those two kids because they're really two talented kids. So I think they playing better every week. They're getting better. Thank you.